Good morning, church. Find a seat. Yeah, well, man, you know, I mean, like, please. Good morning, beautiful gate. Today is Youth Sunday, and today's announcement is BG gets kids beach party right after church at 3:30, and then youth beach party is at 4 to 7:30. And men's breakfast is June 27th at 8:30 a.m. June 28th through 29th is AIM Feet Days. And today I'm Alexandria Chittenden, and I'm so excited to welcome you to Youth Sunday today. We're all so glad to be here with you and just share our love for the Lord with you. We have had an awesome year at Anchor, and we love it when we get to give you all a glimpse into that. We really hope you enjoy our service today. Mwah!
Hey everyone, I'm Jack, and as G said, we're really excited to be leading service here today. And just a friendly reminder to fill out your index cards in those little clear cups in there, to fill out any prayer requests or needs that you might need to be lifted up for. And look at the program so you know what's going on at Beautiful Gate Church today. Today's service is going to go a little bit differently, but it's going to be fun. We want to invite everyone and just go and say hello to everyone, and especially the teenagers, and there's going to be cake in the back, which, yeah, cake. Go grab a piece.
Yes, go grab your cake now, because you're not going to want to get up after this.
to the moon. Okay. Everyone, go find your seats real quick. We're going to be telling a bit of jokes, because if you don't know, we are funny. Funny they got that. It. We're just describing it, but. Okay, so just wait to find people's seats. Okay. Time to be quiet. Trust me, everyone. These jokes are going to knock your socks off. Okay. First joke is, why don't they play cards on the ark? Because Noah was standing on the deck. Pretty funny. Pretty funny.
Jesus be like, why does everyone get presents on my birthday but me?
All right, what time was Adam created? A little before evening.
That wasn't that funny. Hi, Mom. Jesus, Jesus talking to a teenager, and Jesus is like, follow me, and the teenager's just like, on Instagram.
Wasn't that funny? Really, really wasn't. Yeah, sorry. So, why did Noah have to punish the chickens on the ark? For using foul language.
What?
You don't get it.
How does Jesus make tea? He brews it.
All right, funny. okay, so what's Jesus' favorite car?
I don't know.
A Chrysler.
That was the best one. I knew that one. I knew it would land. What did that say?
And that's all. How do I turn the microphone off?
Thank you.
Jack and Henry, my men, are going to lead us. Jack and Henry are going to lead us in a little game because students like to play games before we get serious. So we're going to play a little round of Would You Rather, okay? So Henry is going to ask us Would You Rather, and he will ask the first part. Jack will give you an or. So if you would rather Henry's, you point to Henry. If you would rather Jack's, you point to Jack. So look, if wrong side. If I said, would you rather have short hair or long hair, right? So you would point to who? We're practicing. Okay, we got it. Don't be offended, okay? All right, come on up here, and you're going to give us your would you rather. You got to stand together.
Okay, would you rather have the super strength of Samson
or the wisdom of Solomon?
Would you rather be a fisherman
or a tax collector?
Would you rather live through a famine
or live through the ten 10 plagues of Egypt?
Be baptized by John the Baptist
or hear Paul speak to the a crowd about Jesus.
Would you rather name the animals
or build the ark?
Would you rather have to perform an animal sacrifice
or prepare a dead body for burial?
Would you rather be imprisoned for over 2 years
or be swallowed by a whale?
And you don't know how it ends, so you don't know you're getting out of that whale.
Would you rather face Goliath with only a stone and a slingshot
or wander in the desert for 40 years?
Okay. Is that a chariot? Yeah, you can skip that one. Okay. Would you rather have dinner with Ruth
or Esther?
Would you rather be present at Jesus' birth
or his resurrection?
Would you rather watch Jesus heal a blind man
or watch Jesus walk on water?
Would you rather be thrown into a furnace
or into a lion's den?
Locusts
or plague of frogs.
Right. Judges. Right. Would you rather have a plague of locusts
or a plague of frogs?
Okay. Would you rather spend an hour in heaven
or a week with Jesus on earth?
Good job. Thank you, Jack and Henry. You can keep it. And now we have some friends preparing themselves, as you can see. We have quite an incredible group of Anchor students, and there is not enough time for us all to share our giftedness with you, so we thought we would try to do it in just a fun little way. So you cannot talk until it's over, because they've worked hard on their production, but we're going to play a quick round of charades Bible version, okay? So they are going to perform a story or scene from the Bible, and you are trying to guess what that scene or story is, okay? So remember, don't yell it out until they're done, and we'll give them a clap because they're just so gifted, okay? All right. Nobody's saying okay, okay? Okay. All right. Okay, imagine it's biblically accurate. Okay, what is it? Yes! Woohoo! You're so good. Any guesses? Oh, that's because you were so good. Aww. What was that one? Oh my. You guys know your Bible. And thank you, Abraham and Isaac. She didn't have to sacrifice her son after all. Or he didn't. Dun da da da, and good job. All right. See, aren't they so gifted? We just had to showcase their talent. And now we invite you to worship with us this morning with our special guests, Jacob and Amelie.
Yeah, would you? Oh, yes. We were going to do it. Would you rather? Would you rather hear Amelie sing or me sing? Point.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a tie.
Oh, sorry. Oh, you guys can stand,
yeah,
by the way.
Stand up. Everybody stand up. This is worship.
You guys can sing really loud, too. There's a lot of you. You can all use your beautiful voices.
All right, let's get into this. Love, like the skies are wide, crashing down to bring the world to life. Hope came dancing on an empty grave. Death has lost its rule to the King of grace. Be the crown in the light and sound. Be the fire burning inside out. Be the love casting out
Your freedom is an open door. You are everything I want and more.
You guys have beautiful voices.
Life is Jesus, my captain, my soul's trusted Lord. All my allegiance is rightfully yours.
Would you have a seat and just join me as we pray? Dear God, we just thank you for this incredible opportunity to be surrounded by just these lights and this joy, these students, God, and just their passion and giftedness for you, just how contagious that is. And Lord, we just give you this time, and we just continue on in worship by worshiping you in another way that we hope just glorifies your heart and your name, Lord. We love you, and it's in your name we pray. Amen. As we just stay kind of in an attitude of worship, we have our K through 5th students who have been practicing learning scripture. So if you are one of my cube friends, come on forward. And they are going to just show off a little bit. They are quite impressive. They have been learning a lot of different scripture this year, and I had challenged them to memorize it. We talk about how we have his word hidden in our heart, that we might not sin against him, and that as we walk through life, when we know God's word and when we know scripture, it's easier for us to hear his voice, and it's easier for us to know the right move to make or where he's directing us. What to do when we're tempted. And so we've been talking about that a whole lot this year. And these guys have really risen to the challenge to hide his word in their heart. And so we're just going to show off a little bit. So the way that we do it is I prompt them and they finish it. So we started off we start off every church service with a scripture that reminds us that God is with us. So that one says, where two or more... Awesome. And we just finished up the armor of God. So this one's still a little new for us. I'm going to cue them with the motion. Before that, they know the scripture that says, and before that, we learned the 7 I am statements that Jesus told us. So they are, I am the bread, I am the light, I am the gate, I am the good,
I am the way, I am the resurrection, I am the vine. And that scripture that we were challenged to learn was Jesus Christ is. And then we did Mission Possible and we learned that all things. And last but not least, we talked about a new series with all the yucky stuff from the Bible. And that scripture was, he lifted me. Good job, guys. So that's our year in a nutshell. You guys can find a seat, but Adele and Zoe are going to stay.
Wow.
So Zoe and Adele, come on up here. Zoe and Adele are fifth grade. I never thought I would see this day come, and here it is. I met both of them around the same time in a Bible study that June was doing for their parents. Before I had children, I was actually with child, with Livy, and Adele was stealing my snack in the nursery, and Zoe was just her little fun, sweet, helpful, outgoing self. And I have loved them since the moment I met them, and thankfully I will still get to work with them in Anchor, but they are two gems. When we went to Watermarks, one of the counselors was like, so just FYI, I'm going to need you to send them our way when they're old enough to be counselors, because they naturally like cheered for everyone. They have led this flock of smaller kids where they could have been like, oh, we're so much older, we're so much cooler. Never once did they give that vibe to them whatsoever. They've led them, loved them, piggyback rode them, and just kind of set an example that many kids wouldn't have risen to that challenge and opportunity. And so I can't even express how proud I am of these girls. I love them with all my heart, and you should too, because they're awesome. So give them a hand. You did it. You're done with fifth. Moving on up. And before I give them their gift, I just want you to hear their little voices. So, Zoe, what are you most looking forward to about moving up?
Not being the tallest.
So that's her one complaint, okay? They are, like, way shorter than her. But that's a gift, right? Ladies, tell her. That's a gift, yes. And Adele?
Being with Virginia.
Aww. That is a big responsibility you got, sister. So being with her sister, I love that. Stay right there. I'm giving you a gift. Give them one more hand as they go. And you got a quick glimpse of our kids, the scripture they learned and the serious business, but here's a little snapshot of their year in all its entirety on the screen.
Can't believe we've come this far, and it feels just like getting started. Somehow we're still running like those kids back then, kids back then. Scrape some knees and falling down, but somehow we keep getting back up. Long as there is wonder, gonna keep running, yeah, we'll keep running in this moment. It's electric, can you see it? Can you feel it? This dream inside is still alive today. Yeah, we're on our way. To all
Nothing can hold us back. Nothing can tear us apart. Not life, not death, not the in-between. This is just the start. Don't let them keep you down. Don't let them push you out. We were made to live, to be fierce like lions. Love and forgive. Just keep moving on. Just keep pushing. Chasing down the dead of night. We're bringing hope to the streets. There's a new way of better life. Only one can set the captive free. He's bringing sight back to the blind. Show the lame how to walk and make the dead alive. Just keep moving on. Just keep pushing ahead. Yeah, the new has come. All the old is dead. Set on love. We got that Holy Ghost power. We keep our eyes fixed above. We got that Holy Ghost power. We got our hearts set on love. We got that Holy Ghost power. We keep our eyes fixed above. Just keep moving on. Just keep pushing ahead. Yeah, the new has come. All the old is dead.
We had quite a year, and as you know, your tithes and offerings go to contribute to the incredible ministry that we do, and both here and out in the world. So Virginia is going to share a little bit with us about our offering, and Jacob, yeah.
Hi. Good morning. Like Miss Nikki said, my name is Virginia, and I'm doing the offertory. Sorry, John, I'm taking your place. So we show, I want to share two scriptures with you guys this morning. The first scripture is Romans 5 through 8. I'm so sorry. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we are still sinners, Christ died for us. And the other one is Leviticus 27:30. The tithe is the Lord's. So we show people that we love them by spending time with them. We may show Jesus that we love him by spending time with him. That could be time at church, reading our Bibles, praying, singing, and stuff like that. If we love him, we give our time to him. God has given each of us special talents. We should use those talents to help others and to show our love to the Lord. And God has also asks that we give our money. When you give 10% of what you have to God, that is called a tithe. Now, I understand that sometimes it's hard to give your tithe money to God, and sometimes it's hard not to be nervous about giving your talents, and it's even harder sometimes to give your time. But we need to understand that if it wasn't for God, we wouldn't have any of these things. No. So, Jesus has given so much to us. He even gave his life. Certainly, we can give back to him what he desires. Give your time, talents, and your tithes and offerings. Thank you.
So, hello. Name's Jacob. I'm doing the prayer today. So, let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing our church together today and for the offerings that will be made. Thank you for sending your son to die for us so that we may have a relationship with you and eternal life in heaven. In Deuteronomy 16:17, it says, "Every man shall give as he is able, according to the blessing of the Lord, your God, that he has given you." I pray that everyone here is able to share their time, talents, and treasures with a joyful heart, knowing that everything that they have comes from you. Please bless us and watch over us this week. In your name we pray. Amen.
So our friends are going to come around and collect the offering. Sophie, Katie, and Christian. That's you guys. Them tell you their name real quick before they show off a little scripture that they've learned. So I'm going to hold the microphone far. Keep your mask on.
Oh, my name's Katie.
My name's Jacob.
Hi, my name's Towns.
I'm Jack.
I'm McKinley.
I'm Alexandria, but people call me G.
I'm Caroline.
I'm Virginia.
I'm Maddie.
I'm Riley.
I'm Jackson.
My name's Anthony, and people call me Anthony.
My name is Christian, and people also call me Christian.
I'm Kayla.
I'm Kayla.
I'm Sophie.
Sam.
I'm Jayla.
I'm Ashley.
Henry.
Henry. All right. And these guys, several of them are getting ready to go on mission this summer to either Guatemala or Georgia. It was supposed to be North Carolina. And we're just super impressed by them and proud of them. They have had an incredible year. And something we focused on, we don't have quite as much time. I have every Sunday morning and Sunday afternoon with the kids, but these guys just get the nighttime. So we challenge them to learn one scripture that we want them to hide in their heart. And that is, trust in the Lord.
Before they come down, if you would just extend your hand, and I just want to pray for them. Dear God, I thank you so much, just for these beautiful students, the call that you have on their lives already.
The difference that they've made with their lives already and that they will make, Lord, each of their individual walks, their spirits, their souls, their hearts, their minds, I pray that you would just guard them and protect them as they grow, Lord, as they encounter more of life. I pray that they would also encounter more of you, that you would wrap your arms around them, that you would walk with them, that everywhere they go, everything they encounter, Lord, that they would remember to trust in you with all of their heart and not depend on what they think they know or understand, but that they would look to you in all of their ways and that you would show them which way to go, that you would guide them, that you would light their path, that you would be a lamp unto them, God, and that they would choose your way, Lord. We just seal their destinies, God, their future, their purpose, that you have for them, Lord, and we just pray that they would continue to walk in that and continue to look to you and be a light to this county, even to their homes, their brothers and sisters, and to one another. God, we thank you for the light they are to this church. We love you, and it's in your name we pray. Amen. And you guys may be seated as Amelie comes forward. She is our only senior this year graduating.
It is such a blessing to get to present Amelie up here this morning. I've known Amelie for the last 3 years, and now she's all grown up, and she's up here leading worship this morning. Can we give a round of applause for that? Because what an incredible young worship leader she has become. We just want to, send you off. And what are you doing this upcoming year?
Hi, I'm Amelie. If you guys don't know me, you guys probably all know my family. I actually want to pursue nursing, courtesy of lovely Miss Shun, because she has always been such a great nurse to us. I am pursuing nursing at K-Tech this summer for my CNA, and then I'm going to PVCC to do my RN, and then hopefully UVA or JMU to do my official pediatric training. Yeah.
Well, we celebrate you, Amelie, and we do have a gift coming up for you, Michelle. You're going to pray. Nikki has right here. We have a little gift from the church as you go off, and Shelly, we're going to pray and bless you as we send you off.
Yes, so they... At the beginning of the school year, not knowing what the school year would bring and what the seniors would have in the way of school, a bunch of wonderful ladies came up with a program called Adopt a Senior, and I jumped right on that and picked Amelie. We kind of had to fight over her for a couple people, but I won. Because I couldn't imagine adopting any other senior except for one at my church who has just been amazing to me, my family, my children. She just comes from an amazing family, and I was trying to sit there and think back how long I've known this young lady, and it just made me feel old. So, this girl, she texted me this week after her mom had surgery and said, "What can I do for you next week when you have your surgery? Can I go grocery shopping?" That's just the heart that this girl has. She wanted to take care of me, and her mom just has her. I'm like, "Go take care of your mom." But she's just like that. She took Sophie home from Anchor a lot. She just radiates the Lord. And so I just wanted to pray that all famous Bible verse from Jeremiah 29:11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope in a future. Then you will call upon me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart." And I just pray that after today, after your graduation, as you go forth with these plans, that you will keep God close at all times. I know you will. But through the valleys and everything that you go through, because Welcome to adulthood. We just love you and so proud of you and everything that you've accomplished over the years. You have just matured into a wonderful young lady. So can I have you guys extend your hand to Amelie? And as we... Dear Heavenly Father, we just bring this young, beautiful woman before you, this woman of Jesus that loves you and just wants your will for her life, Lord, and that you will just be there right beside her along the way, that she will know your presence, feel it every single day, that she will seek you with all her heart, and that you will just guide her path, that you will just be with her through the highs and the lows, and just continue to let her know that you are there for her, Lord. And we just pray for her as she graduates this Friday, Lord, that she will enjoy every moment and that she will just, she's such a hard worker, Lord, just give her the rest that she needs and the guidance and the faith to carry her through from now on. In your name we pray these things. Amen.
Amen.
And now we'd like to show you a little glimpse into our anchor year. So focus your attention on the screen.
Lately I've been reeling, watching the nightly news. Don't seem to find the rhythm, just wanna sing the blues. Feels like a song that never stops, feels like it's never gonna. Gotta get that fire back in my bones before my heart turns into stone. So when somebody please pass the megaphone, I'll shout it on the count of three.
Joy, 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 joy down in my heart, down.
wanted my heart to stay. I've been empty. When I'm low, you fill the cup. Yeah, but my ego fights back, telling me that I'm ready to grab the wheel and take control. But I'll crash if I don't let myself let go. You put the X on my faded map. Draw me a line back to where you're at. Patient when I try to move too fast. I get this feeling, I get this feeling, I get this feeling in my spirit when I'm low. I hear it calling like a compass in my soul, saying, child, come on back now, you've been gone too long. Let me lead you back where you belong. Right next to me. Right next to me. I've been captive by the plans I try to make. Yeah, I've been selfish, 'cause callous hearts, they die hard like habits that I know I gotta break. Ain't it good to know that help is on the way? In my soul, saying, child, come on back now, you've been gone too long. Let me lead you back where you belong. Right next to me. Oh, oh, oh. You know I tried to do it on my own.
If you don't know, this is Sam Halpin. Yes. He graduated already, but he has been helping, kind of interning, assisting at Anchor. He's an incredible role model, and we just have the pleasure and joy to hear him speak. He just returned from Kentucky on mission trip. He's not tired, I don't think. Anyway, it's a joy to have him. It's a joy to have him in the ministry and to speak to us today.
Hello. So like Nikki said, I didn't graduate this year, but I graduated last year, and I spoke it last year Sunday, but June asked me to speak again, so I said yes. So as many of you know, my original plan before COVID was to participate and move into a 2-year stewardship program at Watermark's camp. While in the stewardship program, I was going to do online classes at PVCC. I eventually lost the Watermark's experience, but I did take classes online as well as have many more life-changing experiences and opportunities. I had no job for a while, though, and fell into a trap of depression over the repetitiveness of my behavior, such as playing video games and YouTube. It was the same thing, and often there wasn't much physical activity involved. At the start of the peak COVID months, I got a job at Food Lion working produce and was getting my fair share of steps in, but ended up having cut hours that ultimately led to no hours, so once again, I was without a job. Then for about 2 months or so, that repetitive, unhealthy behavior circled back around. Then one day, my mom asked me if I would apply for a job at the daycare here at Beautiful Gate. My initial reply was, no, I don't like kids. But I couldn't have been any more wrong in this judgment. This job has single-handedly changed my life. Seeing the kids' faces when I walked in the room every day was amazing, and not gonna lie, it nearly brings tears to my eyes every time. But it isn't as noticeable with the mask on. But now, since I'm fully vaccinated, I'm afraid it might be more noticeable. 2020 to the beginning of 2021 was an adventure, to say the least. Of all the things that happened back in 2020, my scariest experience through this whole COVID-filled time happened in January. In January, my best friend, basically my second brother Dylan, was sent to the ICU unit with chest pain and breathing problems. Eventually, it was determined that he had pancreatitis. When I tell you I don't think I've prayed for anything this personal to me in so long, I wouldn't be lying. Dylan is family, and I was scared of losing him. Fortunately, he made it through, and I got to meet him shortly after and found out that the doctors had basically told him that he was on his deathbed and there wasn't really much else they could do. This tore me apart, but at the same time, it made me realize something. Prayer really does pay off. Through this time of uncertainty, one thing always worked, and that was prayer. Stay steady in the Lord and his timing, because he will do amazing things. I don't have my own car insurance, or really any of my own, but that's because no matter what, I'll always be insured by God. Shifting gears a little bit, as you guys heard, I just got back from Kentucky, and this isn't even, I didn't even have this typed down, but it was on my mind. You know, before I went to Kentucky, I was thinking, you know, Georgia was my main mission, and Georgia was going to be the fun one, and Kentucky's kind of just like, whatever, you know, like, just something I'm going on just because. But, it was a great week, and I learned a lot. And Friday night, I had grown, as you know, I was there working with kids who suffer from autism and have some tragic backstories. So I grew close with one of the boys in particular the last couple of days. And on Friday, he got baptized. I don't think I've hugged someone that much in a while, to be honest with you. I didn't care he was wet. The last time I saw him, he said something to me, and it really stuck out. He said, "You are one of the realest people, or one of the realest people that he's ever, that's ever done this with him." And that really opened my eyes a little bit. And I received a note from him. And I want to share that with you this morning. It says, "It was fun meeting you, and I hope you make it home safe. And I will always pray for you, and I hope I see you again." I don't know if I'll ever see him again. But, you know, he definitely changed my life, and that experience definitely changed my life. So, I just want to say thank you to the Kentucky team and the church for giving me this opportunity, and thank you for letting me share. Thank you.
I just think you have a future in public speaking. Thank you, Sam. He's somebody. Listen, and we get to say he came from this village, right?
Mm.
Sam, God has an incredible call on your life. Thank you for sharing that with us and being so vulnerable. We love you. And now I want to do something that June did not approve. because, I know, because she would say no, but here's the thing that I think. we have a unique privilege here. I don't know if you know that. Hopefully you saw that. Hopefully you felt that in your spirit, but the Lord is always at work at Beautiful Gate. He always has been. I believe he always will be. And there's something that's different about us than other places, and that is a leader who prioritizes youth and children. Should you not do that, your church will be dead. There's no future. There's no joy. There's no life. There's nothing when you don't put the kids first, when you don't put students first. So they're first in the budget. I say, can we buy it? She says, yep, buy two. I say, can we do it? She says, yep, let's do it again. I say, can we go? She says, yep, how far, right? No matter what it is, she makes it happen for students and for children. And she always has, and that's the model that I'll follow the rest of my life. When the opportunity came to help with Anchor, frankly, I was a little bit like Sam, and I was like, I don't really like teenagers anymore. I'm old. Little did I know, I couldn't have been more wrong either. And they are probably the most fun and life-giving thing in my life right now. I love my kids, and then they're next. But for real, it's contagious. And I just want to acknowledge that you've chosen a place that's going to raise your kids in the love and admonition of the Lord. And should they stray, they'll come back. Because they know it in their heart. They've hidden it in their heart. They know it in their spirit. They encounter the Holy Spirit, as you saw, Sam. They know the difference. They know right and wrong. And so just rest assured. Hopefully they don't ever stray. Don't stray like that little sheep. But if they do, they're coming back home because they know what home is. And so I just want to acknowledge that June's created that home. The Lord in her, obviously. But she has to be a willing vessel. And so I just stand in awe of the vessel that she is and that she continues to be. And so we just wanted to take 1 second to serve her. So two of our students, Maddie and Riley, were welcomed the opportunity to wash Miss June's feet. So June, if you would, come sit in our chair. Because as you know... Come on up, girls. Jesus himself washed his disciples' feet. And so we fully take advantage of the opportunity to do that for you, June.
Of eternal promise, stirring in your sons and daughters, earth revealing heaven's wonders. Spirit, come, what you spoke is now unfolding. All your children shall be old. Dreams awaken in this moment. Spirit, come, pour it out. Let your love run over here and now. Let your glory fill. Pour it out, let your love run over here and now.
If you could just keep the music playing, we're just going to pray for June. Dear God, I thank you for June. I thank you for the call that you put on her life all those years ago. Thank you that she still walks in it and follows it and honors it and submits to it.
no matter what the cost. Lord, I thank you for the lives that are changed because of it. I thank you for the careers and the passions and the dreams that have come true because of it. Lord, we know that it's all you. There's no denying it. You have been at work in her since as long as I have been alive. But I thank you that she's been a willing participant in that journey, God. I thank you for what she pours in. And I pray that what she sees today and continues to see and what she has seen will just give her the energy and joy and strength to continue, and that she would just see the fruit, God, that you would just give her a glimpse, just a small glimpse. We know we can't even really understand until we get to the other side, Lord, but I just pray that you would just give her little snapshots of just all the lives and spirits and souls that have been impacted because of her faithfulness, God, because of her humility. Not that she's perfect, God, but that she keeps going, that she never quits, and that she'll try anything you tell her to try, God. We thank you for that. And we thank you that Beautiful Gate is a place that puts children and students above anything else, God. So that the future is secure, so that there's a purpose, and so that your word and your purpose continue to reign through the earth, Lord, because of these students. We love you, and it's in your name we pray. Amen. Thank you for submitting to me, June. Well, we hope that you enjoyed our Youth Sunday.
Shelly Farley is having surgery, so we do want to pray.
Okay. Shelly Farley is having surgery, so we're going to pray.
And Stacy Hamill walked in today. She's been sick and recovering, and Mama's coming to town, and we just have to pray for health and well-being and strength, and for her husband as well, for their household. So we praise God that she made it today. We've been praying mightily for you girls, so, and have been for Shelley. So we just pray that God brings you through this surgery on June 15th. Please keep her in your prayers, and we'll talk about food. Maybe Kirsten will engineer that. Thank you.
She's so submissive too.
That's how it is. Yeah. And so we want to pray for this.
I didn't know she was just exhorting you to do that or if we should. Dear God, we just lift up Stacy. God, thank you for her ferocity fighting this and coming today to be part of what's going on in her girls' lives, though she's uncomfortable and though she's been through the ringer. We pray that you just deliver her and that the medicine would be efficient and quick and effective. And we pray for Shelly that you would be in that room, that you would be in every tool and vessel that you use, God, to just bring her through it just without any incident, God, and that it would accomplish what it should and what it's intended to, and that you would just be with her as she recovers. And Camille's continued recovery. Lord, that you would just continue to be with her, her shining, beautiful spirit that is just contagious. And just look at the fruit of her life that we got to be part of today. And so we just pray that you would be with her. We love you, and it's in your name we pray. And somebody's saying, Nikki, yes. It's unscripted.
We have another surprise. It was not approved by Nikki. So it's for Nikki and Kate, because they have been the ones who have helped us with Anchor and been like the leaders of Anchor. So we got them a little something as a surprise, as a thank you for helping all of us. It's from all of us.
Sorry, I had to make service go a little longer.
Thank you.
Oh, my God.
Thank you, both of us. Thank you. I was just so moved to say something. Sorry, I had to make service go on a little longer because my heart was full and my heart was stirring. Nikki said something earlier that really, really resonated with me, and talking about how being involved with these students throughout the year was one of the best things that bring joy and brought life to our weeks. We love you guys so much, and I just wanted to say thank you guys as much as we love pouring out to you guys. Thank you so much because you bring so much joy and light into our lives.
And now you may go.
No.
Go! Just kidding. We're going to sing one more song. So stand up. Woohoo!
We do. We can't hang out later. What are we doing?
Life, you are love, you bring light
We rejoice, we cheer, we celebrate that we get to celebrate the lives and these children that get to be in our lives. I just wanted to pray us out because my heart was stirring for it. Dear Heavenly Father, as we leave here today and we get to celebrate that the year is over, God, we remember that you are not finished yet, that you are not done moving in the lives of each and every one of our students, God. That we lift you up as we lift them up. That, God, we go, as some of our students move up, that they go fearlessly. And over the summer, we go and be the hands and the feet of your name. In your name I pray. Amen.